हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू एडिटॉक्स एकेडमी। इन टुडेज क्लास वी विल स्टार्ट विद अ न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज ब्रीदिंग एंड एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेस। ब्रीदिंग एंड एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेस, व्हाट इज ब्रीदिंग? ब्रीदिंग इज इनहेलेशन एक्सहेलेशन, राइट? इनहेलेशन, इनहेलिंग द एयर एंड एक्सहेलिंग द एयर, दैट इज ब्रीदिंग। ब्रीदिंग इज सो breathing is a biophysical process which involves inhaling and exhaling of air through lungs. ठीक है, breathing is a biophysical process which involves the inhaling air and exhaling air through lungs. ठीक है, breathing is a biophysical process which involves inhaling and exhaling of air through lungs. You understood now what is breathing. Now what is respiration and what is difference between breathing and respiration? See, breathing, it involves inhalation, exhalation. Breathing, it takes place in lungs. Whereas respiration, see, respiration is a biochemical process which involves breakdown of glucose to release energy in the form of ATP. Respiration is a biochemical process which involves breakdown of glucose to release or to generate energy. You understood what is the difference between breathing and respiration? See, breathing is a process which involves inhalation and exhalation of air, whereas respiration, it involves breakdown of glucose. Glucose is broken down to release energy. ठीक है, you understood the difference between breathing and respiration? Stop. See, oxygen is utilized by the organisms to indirectly break down simple molecules like glucose, amino acids, fatty acids. Glucose, amino acids, fatty acids. These are the simple molecules we know. So, what happens? See, these molecules are obtained from digestive system, right? The end products of digestive system are glucose, amino acids, fatty acids. These are absorbed, right? These substances are absorbed. Now, see, oxygen breaks down this simple molecules to get energy. Oxygen break down this simple molecules to derive energy to perform various activities. Got it? Oxygen breaks down. Oxygen is utilized by the organisms to break down glucose, amino acids and fatty acids to derive energy to perform various activities. ठीक है, यानी ग्लूकोज इट कंबाइंस विद दिस ऑक्सीजन एंड इट रिलीजेस एनर्जी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एटीपी मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड नाउ दिस एनर्जी विल बी यूटिलाइज्ड बाय द बॉडी टू परफॉर्म वेरियस एक्टिविटीज. गॉट इट? एंड इन दिस प्रोसेस कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इज रिलीज्ड. कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड विच इज हार्मफुल इज ऑल्सो रिलीज्ड ड्यूरिंग द अबव कैटाबॉलिक रिएक्शन. ओके, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इज रिलीज्ड during the above catabolic reaction. Now what do you understand by catabolic reaction? See, there are two types of reaction: anabolic reaction, catabolic reaction. Anabolic reaction is the one in which a compound is synthesized. See, two compounds, they will combine together and form a third substance. ठीक है, compound is synthesized. Synthesis of a product, synthesis of compound takes place in anabolic reaction, whereas in catabolic reaction, a substance, it gets broken down into simple substances. That is catabolic. Okay, in catabolic reaction, substance gets broken down. See, here, glucose, amino acid, they get broken down. Got it? So it is therefore evident that oxygen has to be continuously provided to the cell. Means the cell needs oxygen. The cells need oxygen. So every cell of our body should be provided oxygen. And CO2 produced by the cells has to be released out. And CO2 will be produced, which has to be released out. Got it? So oxygen is required. Oxygen is to be provided to the cell. And carbon dioxide has to be released out of the cell. Got it? What is this? This is breathing. The process of exchange of oxygen from the atmosphere with carbon dioxide produced by the cell is called breathing, commonly known as respiration. You understood what is breathing and what is respiration? breathing, it means inhalation, exhalation, and respiration, breakdown of glucose to provide energy. Got it? See, now respiratory organs. Which are the organs involved in respiration? Which are the organs involved? No, this is respiratory organs. See, this is human respiratory system. Human respiratory system. What all are the organs that are involved in human respiratory system? See, we have a pair of external nostrils opening out above the upper lips. So nostrils, see nose, it has a pair of external nostrils. It leads to the nasal chamber through the nasal passage. These nostrils, they lead to the nasal chamber through the nasal passage. The nasal chamber opens into pharynx. Got nose, external nostrils, then nasal chamber. Now this nasal chamber, it opens into pharynx. Pharynx is a portion which is common passage for food and air. See, remember, do you remember pharynx? Pharynx has three portions. Nasopharynx, that is behind the nose. Then oropharynx, that is behind mouth. See, mouth is also known as buccal cavity, oral cavity, right? So oro. So the portion of the pharynx that is behind the mouth is called oropharynx. And after that, laryngopharynx, behind larynx, that is laryngopharynx. See, which are the three parts of pharynx? Nasopharynx, oropharynx, and laryngopharynx. Okay? See, oropharynx is a common passage for food and air. Okay? For food and air. Which is the common passage for food and air? Oropharynx. Oropharynx is the common passage for food and air. Got it? See now. The pharynx opens through the larynx region into the trachea. This pharynx, it opens in trachea. Larynx is a cartilaginous box which helps in sound production and hence also called sound box. Remember, what is sound box? Larynx. Larynx is called sound box. Larynx is called sound box because it helps in sound production. Larynx help in sound production. Okay? Larynx help in sound production. Now, very important thing. During swallowing, glottis can be covered by a thin elastic cartilaginous flap called epiglottis to prevent the entry of food in larynx. See, now we saw that pharynx is a common passage for food and air. Pharynx is a common passage for food and air. So food and air both are traveling together. So there is possibility that food might enter the glottis. There is possibility that food might enter the glottis. So glottis gets covered by a thin elastic cartilaginous flap that is called epiglottis. See, remember epiglottis, okay? See, epiglottis means the flap which covers the glottis. See, okay? So pharynx, which is common passage for food and air, so there might be that food might enter the glottis. So to prevent the entry of food in glottis, the glottis gets covered by a thin elastic cartilaginous flap that is called glottis. Got it? To prevent the entry of food in larynx. Okay, see now. Trachea. Now what is trachea? Trachea is a straight tube extending up to the mid thoracic cavity. Which divides at the level of fifth thoracic vertebra into right and left primary bronchi. See, trachea. Trachea is a straight tube. It is a straight tube. Extends up to mid thoracic cavity. You know, head, thorax, abdomen, thorax. Okay, thorax. So up to mid thorax, trachea is there, and it divides. This trachea, it gets divided. See, this is trachea. Can you see this? These are C-shaped cartilaginous rings, and it divides. Can you see? See, it is dividing into right and left bronchi. This is right bronchi, this is left bronchi. This is right bronchi, this is left bronchi. And what is it? This is fifth thoracic vertebrae. You know, there are vertebrae. So this division is at the point of fifth thoracic vertebra. Okay? So this division is at the point that is fifth thoracic vertebra, okay, into right and left bronchi. Now each bronchi undergo repeated divisions to form secondary and tertiary bronchi and bronchioles up ending up in very thin terminal bronchioles. See, now you saw that trachea is a straight tube, and at the level of fifth thoracic vertebra it gets divided into right and left bronchi. Okay, now this bronchi, it will again divide. It will again divide into primary bronchi. Then it will again divide into secondary bronchi. It will again divide into tertiary bronchi. And then it will end in bronchioles. It will end in bronchioles. Got it? See, बहुत सारे divisions जैसे tree. Tree में कैसे होते हैं? Main, main branch, उसमें से फिर branches, right? Same thing is happening here. Primary bronchioles, secondary bronchioles and tertiary bronchioles. Got it? Primary bronchioles, secondary bronchioles, trachea, it will get bifurcated into two primary bronchi. Trachea, two primary bronchi, and these primary bronchi will be called right bronchi and left bronchi. Now this primary bronchi, it will enter the lung and it will divide into secondary bronchi. Now this secondary bronchi, it will further divide into tertiary bronchi. Okay, and now this tertiary bronchi, it will divide several times and it will end up forming bronchioles. Got it? It will end up in forming bronchioles. ठीक है, the trachea, primary, secondary, tertiary bronchi and initial bronchioles are supported by incomplete cartilaginous rings. They are supported by incomplete cartilaginous rings. Each terminal bronchiole give rise, see terminal bronchiole, you understood till bronchiole, right? Primary bronchi, secondary bronchi, tertiary bronchi, after that bronchioles. And now this bronchiole, this terminal bronchiole, it will give rise to a number of very thin, irregular walled and vascularized. What do you understand by vascularized? Vascularized means blood supply. If the blood supply for a structure is more, it is said to be vascularized. ठीक है, वास्कुलराइज यानी उसकी ब्लड सप्लाई बहुत ज़्यादा है. वास्कुलराइज स्ट्रक्चर का मतलब होता है ब्लड सप्लाई बहुत ज़्यादा है, ठीक है, यानी एल्वियोलाई जो है उनकी ब्लड सप्लाई बहुत ज़्यादा है. ठीक है, चलो. ईच टर्मिनल ब्रोंक्योल इट गिव राइज टू अ नंबर ऑफ वेरी थिन, दे आर वेरी थिन इरेग्युलर वॉल, देयर वॉल इज इरेग्युलर एंड वास्कुलराइज बैग लाइक स्ट्रक्चर कॉल्ड एल्वियोलाई. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्ट्रक्चर एल्वियोलाई. द ब्रांचिंग नेटवर्क ऑफ ब्रोंकाई, ब्रोंक्योल एंड एल्वियोलाई कंप्राइज द लंग. ठीक है, ऑल दिस कंप्राइज द लंग. ठीक है, क्या क्या चीजें प्रेजेंट है? नोज, देन इट हैज अ पेयर ऑफ एक्सटर्नल नॉस्ट्रल्स. This nostrils, it lead to the nasal chamber through the nasal passage, and this nasal chamber, it opens into pharynx. Pharynx has three parts: nasopharynx, oropharynx and laryngopharynx. Pharynx is a common passage for food and air. Pharynx opens through the larynx into trachea. It opens in trachea, and what is larynx called? Larynx is called sound box because it helps in sound production. And this is very important. What is epiglottis? As pharynx is a common passage for food and air, so to prevent the entry of food in glottis, the glottis, it gets covered by a thin cartilaginous flap called epiglottis. ठीक है, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एपीग्लॉटिस ड्यूरिंग स्वेलोइंग ग्लॉटिस इट गेट्स कवर्ड बाय अ थिन इलास्टिक कार्टिलेजनस फ्लैप कॉल्ड एपीग्लॉटिस. to prevent entry of food into larynx. Then trachea, it is a straight tube. It extends up to mid thoracic cavity, and here it divides into two primary bronchi. Called right bronchus and left bronchus. ठीक है, right bronchus and left bronchus, and this primary bronchus, it enters the lung. Right bronchus enters right lung, left bronchus enters left lung, and here it further divides into secondary bronchi. It further divides into tertiary bronchi, and tertiary bronchi, they end up in bronchioles. Terminal bronchioles, and this terminal bronchioles, they give rise to a number of very thin, irregular walled and vascularized bag-like structures called alveoli. Now, ठीक है, यहाँ तक completed alveoli. चलो, now the branching network of bronchi, bronchioles and alveoli, it comprise the lungs. We have two lungs which are covered by a double layered pleura. See, lungs have a double layer. They have a double layered covering. The covering of the lungs is called pleura. It is double layered with a pleural fluid between them. It is double layered, so two layers. So between these two layers, pleural fluid is present between these two layers. And what is the role of this pleural fluid? To reduce friction. See, there are two walls, so it might possible that during inhalation and during exhalation, the walls, they might come in contact with each other and create friction. So to reduce the friction, pleural fluid is present between the two layers. Pleural fluid, it reduces the friction on the lung surface. See, the outer pleural membrane is in contact with the thoracic lining. Outer is in contact with thoracic lining and inner is in contact with lungs. Outer one, see this, there is thorax, and within thorax lungs are present. So outer membrane, see, the outer membrane is called parietal membrane, and the one that, see, lungs are covered by a double layered. The inner layer that is in contact with the lung is called visceral layer. And the outer pleural membrane that is in contact with the thorax is called parietal layer. Visceral layer, parietal layer. Remember the name of the layer. Visceral layer is the inner layer. Parietal layer is the outer layer. Okay? Visceral layer, parietal layer. Visceral layer is in contact with the lung surface. Parietal layer is in contact with the thoracic cavity. Okay? Inner pleural membrane is in contact with the lung surface, that is visceral layer, and outer is parietal layer, and between these layers is pleural fluid. What is the role of this fluid? It reduces the friction between these two layers. The part starting with the external nostrils up to the terminal bronchioles constitutes the conducting part, whereas the alveoli and their ducts form the respiratory or exchange part of respiratory system. See, there are two parts, conducting part and respiratory part. Conducting part, I'll explain you what is conducting part and what is respiratory part. The conducting part, it transports atmospheric air to alveoli, clears it from foreign particles, humidifies, and also brings the air to body temperature. Exchange part is the actual site of diffusion of O2 and CO2 between blood and atmospheric air. See, conducting part means it conducts the air, transports the air. So, the part starting from external nostrils up to the terminal bronchioles. See, from the nostrils to the terminal bronchioles. See, the terminal bronchioles, they have alveoli, right? They are that irregular vascularized bag-like structure called alveoli. And the actual diffusion of O2 and CO2 takes place in alveoli. What is the role of alveoli? The actual diffusion of oxygen and carbon dioxide. Okay? Means oxygen will enter and carbon dioxide will be released. This takes place in alveoli. So this alveoli, it is called the exchange part. As exchange takes place there, exchange of O2 and CO2 between blood and atmospheric air takes place there, and the rest of the system, that is from external nostrils to terminal bronchioles, means kya kya aagaya isme, external nostrils, nasal chamber, pharynx, larynx, trachea, primary bronchi, third secondary bronchi, tertiary bronchi, terminal bronchioles. This whole is conducting part, whereas the alveoli and their ducts, they form the respiratory or exchange part, as exchange of gases takes place there. Okay, conducting part, it transports the atmospheric air to alveoli. What is the role of conducting part? It transports the atmospheric air to alveoli. It clears it from foreign particles. It humidifies and also brings the air to body temperature. And exchange part is the site of actual diffusion of O2 and CO2 between blood and atmospheric air. Okay, see, the lungs are situated in thoracic chamber, which is anatomically an airtight chamber. The lungs are situated in thoracic chamber, and this thoracic chamber, it is an airtight chamber. Thoracic chamber is airtight chamber. It is airtight chamber. You know what is the meaning of airtight, right? It is airtight chamber. And see, thoracic chamber is formed dorsally by vertebral column. Dorsally means backside. You know the vertebral column, right? So dorsal means backside. Thoracic chamber ki boundaries dekh rahe hain. So thoracic chamber dorsally by vertebral column, ventrally by sternum. See, you have to remember this, right? Dorsally vertebral column, ventrally sternum, laterally lateral sides, laterally by the ribs, and lower side by dome shaped diaphragm. You know what is diaphragm is? Diaphragm, it is a dome shaped structure. It separates the thorax and abdomen. Diaphragm separates thorax and abdomen. Okay, got it? So dorsally thoracic chamber, dorsally vertebral column, ventrally sternum, laterally ribs, and lower side by dome shaped diaphragm. Samajh gaya na aap? Dorsally यानी कि पीछे की साइड वर्टिब्रल कॉलम, वेंट्रली आगे की तरफ स्टर्नम, लेटरली साइड में रिब्स, और नीचे की साइड लोअर साइड बाय डोम शेप डायाफ्राम. व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ डायाफ्राम? इट सेपरेट्स थोरैक्स एंड एब्डोमेन. द एनाटॉमिकल सेटअप इज सच दैट एनी चेंज इन द वॉल्यूम ऑफ थोरेसिक कैविटी विल बी रिफ्लेक्टेड इन द लंग्स पल्मोनरी कैविटी. Such an arrangement is essential for breathing, as we cannot directly alter the pulmonary volume. This I will explain you in the next class. Okay? ठीक है, तो यहाँ तक आप study कर लेना. अभी हमने human respiratory system के सिर्फ parts पढ़े हैं. Next class we'll study about the mechanism of breathing. Okay? Goodbye. Take care.